A veteran journalist named Mike Russell has written a lengthy article about your alleged past. A lot of explosive things in that. What can you tell us? Is this article accurate?
So, brothers and sisters, this is a remarkable achievement which you have seen. How, you know, ordinary youth is turned into, you know, a way like times. And they have gone back with the people and they're treating them in the same, you know, self-defense and use of water.
If you want to make me look like a double, whatever, you know, 007, whatever, listen.
Is that true, though?
Listen, you know, maybe whatever, 5%, whatever the story is true.
You know, I come from a crazy place too. You know, like I grew up very rough life, you know. I threw a lot of things, but I'm a young kid from Egypt. I come here as 18 years old. I have a rough road. I grew up in this country. I come here very young. I grew up very rough.
What do you mean, since
you're I used to get in a lot of things when I was younger. I used
like
to get
fights? On, street fights?
Whatever. Whatever I used to get.
What do you mean?
But I grew up like was
where in Egypt?
I've been stabbed probably over 11 times. I got shot. Like I'm not. I'm, you know, I'm
been
a father.
Stabbed 11 times.
Yes, when I was a kid.
Why?
I really respect the media for not talking any, because a lot of the people want to talk about negative stuff. The media focus about the positive stuff I did, and I am a very positive person. I'm not perfect. Everybody makes mistakes in life, but everything I did in the past, I'm very proud of.
We are establishing training camps at present in other countries, some other Islamic countries for Muslims. And you can reach us, you know, at the Google University offices in upstate New York, or in Canada, or Michigan, or in South Carolina, or in Pakistan, wherever we are, you can reach us.
If I was a bad person, you know, on this management game, you know, not manage guys like Enzo Gracie, Frankie Edgar, you know, Mr. Rafael Busanios, Fabrizio Verdum. These people really know me. Everybody else, they want to talk about me. I really do not give a shit. And I don't give a crap. But
a lot has been written about you. We don't have to beat around. What can you say? When can you talk about? There's all this stuff. I want to know what's true and what's not.
Listen to me. You know, when you have a bunch of fucking morons talking shit, this, when you gotta get a hit, when you gotta be successful, you gotta have hit.
Are you saying the things that have been written about your past are untrue?
The fucking, these people just are jealous, envious.
But it's one thing to say, oh, you saw
but
cancer.
But
it's another thing to talk about some, you know, serious.
But it's okay. If I'm like this crazy criminal or I'm a terrorist, what the fuck? I'm living in this country, not, you know, like not handcuffed in some federal prison somewhere. If you want to criticize me or you want to talk shit about me, you understand? Like, listen, all these people, I have over 100 fighters. I got 50 fighters in the UFC, double any other fucking manager out there. You know? I don't accomplish this by being a scumbag, a fucking thief, a fucking bullshit guy.
Can you clear up the whole Olympic controversy for us? Were you a part of the Olympic team in the 90s? There are some, again, who are claiming that this isn't accurate. What can you tell us about your involvement with the Egyptian Olympic team?
Listen, you know, you can talk to people, some of the Olympic coaches, you know, Eddie ladies and all the people I train and live with at the Olympic Training Center. You know, I was 132 pounds, 60 kilos, went to the Olympic game, I should have been 60 kilos.
Atlanta, right?
Atlanta, I have a hard time making weight. I was on the team. I failed to make weight classes. And listen, this is something I'm not proud of. You know, make it this far and not make weight at the age of 18 years old. Something I'm not proud of. You didn't see me promote it. People asked me about it. I never really promoted it. I mentioned it in a couple of interviews. People asked about it. But listen, you know, I do not consider myself. I made the team. On paper, I made an Olympic team. But, you know, but I did not make weight. This is an embarrassment for me, and if people, you know, take it any wrong, like I bragged about it, I never did, and if somebody did, hey, I'm sorry, you know, but this is the true story, and this is something I'm not proud of.
Fair enough. We'll leave it at that.